If you are an Amazon seller looking to save time and maximize the performance of your PPC campaigns, then this video is for you. Today, I am gonna diving into the most efficient tools within Amazon, which is called bulk operations. Using this tool, you can optimize your PPC campaigns within very short time. So without any delay, let's start today's discussion. Okay, so from my Seller Central account, if I go to the Campaign Manager tab, you can see from here, you will see the options bulk operations. So let me click on this tab. Here, first of all, you need to create a customized spreadsheet and then you can download this. So first of all, let me select the date range like last week. And then I will just include the data what actually I will need. For example, the sponsored product data, sponsored brands data, and sponsored display data. So now I can click on the create spreadsheet for download, and then the report will be downloaded within like 10 to 15 minutes. Anyway, I have already downloaded this report, so let's open this one. Here in this report, on the portfolios tab, I do not need to optimize anything. I can go to the sponsored product campaigns tab. And here at first, I will create another two new columns. One will be old bid, next one will be new bids. I will explain you later on why actually I created these two columns. Anyway, now filter this report. Here actually I will do some simple filtration. First of all, I will check the keywords that have higher ACoS. I will reduce their bids. And then I will check the keywords that have lower ACoS. I will increase their bids. And then I will check the keywords that are not getting any sales but getting clicks. I will also adjust their bids. So let's start one by one. First of all, if I check the highest ACoS campaigns, let's sort the ACoS with largest to smallest. Here you can see that there are some targets that have like 58% ACoS, 54%, 53%. So let's check all the targets that have over 30% ACoS. So here around 5 to 6 targets I have over 30% ACoS. Let's check their current bids first. So here on this column you can see their current bid rates. Let's put here. So here I just put the old bids and now I wanna decrease their bids. So if I look at the CPC, I can see that some of the CPC is very low and some of the CPC is like high. So based on the CPC, I will adjust the bid because let me show you an example. For example, you can see here, these targets current bid is 1.46 and the CPC is 0.83. So if I, let's say, like reduce the bids 20 cent, so it will be like 1.26. But still there is a chance that Amazon can charge the same. I mean, they can again charge like 0.83. So in that case, I need to reduce the bids like less than the current CPC. For example, I can set is like 0.70 or 0.60 within this range so that Amazon can charge lower. So I will reduce the bids now based on the current CPC. So for the first one, let's select 0.25. And for next one, I can see the average CPC is 1.55, although the bid is 0.52. This is actually why maybe this target has the placement or up and down strategy. That's why the CPC is higher than the current bids rate. Okay, I wanna reduce the bids more. Let's say 0.30. Next one, I can set 0.10. And then here the next one is current bids rate 60 cent and the CPC is 48 cent. So let's select 35 cent. And for the next one, I am gonna set the new bid as 30 cent. This one gonna be 70 cent. Okay, so I have updated the new bids for the high ACoS campaigns. Anyway, let's color this. And now I will check the targets that have lower ACoS. Now let's do another filter. From the ACoS column, I can go to the number filters and let's select less than let's do 20%. So again, I will copy the current bits rate for these targets. Let's copy this and put here. So based on the CPC, let's again select the new bits. So as I will increase their bits rate, so I will increase at least 10 to 15 cents for each targets. So let's select and formula. So I'm gonna increase 15 cents for each targets. Okay, so I have updated the new bits for the lower ACoS targets. And now let's check all the targets that just got clicks with no sales. So if I go to the sales column and select only zero data, and let's sort with clicks, like largest to smallest. And then you can see some targets that have higher than 20 clicks with no sales. So let's check their current bits rate. Let's copy this and paste here. Okay, now I'm gonna reduce the bits too for these targets. So again, I'm gonna reduce the bits based on the CPC. Here for the first one, the CPC is 9 cent. So I'm gonna keep this below 9 cent. And then the next one, I'm gonna keep this 40 cent. This way, I'm gonna input all the new bits data. So I have updated all the new bits for these targets. So I am done with all the targets of sponsored product campaigns. Similarly, you can check the sponsored brand campaigns data and also sponsored display campaigns data. Now let me explain you why actually I put the new two columns here, which is old bits and the new bits. Actually, I will keep this data for my next adjustment. So when after 1 week, I will again download this report. I can check the previous reports too and analyze what was the changes I made before. Anyway, now the final thing I need to do, let's filter all the changes to targets. Now what I need to do, I need to update the new bits in the bit column. So after updating the new bits, I need to go to another column, which is called the C column, is operation. And here I must need to put update. So now the sheet is ready. I can download this report and go to the campaign manager. And here I can upload this file. So this way you can optimize all the sponsored product, sponsored brand and sponsored brands data and just upload this file. So if I show you one more thing, if I go to my campaign manager tab, so now see that I have total 167 active campaigns. If I would go one by one campaigns, that it would take at least 2 to 3 hours to optimize all the campaigns. But using this bulk sheet, I can optimize all the campaigns within like 10 to 20 minutes. So this is how you can save your time at least during this peak time and optimize your campaigns in most efficient way. Before ending the video, I'm gonna share one drawback of these bulk operations, which is you can't select different date range to check the performance. So keep in mind that when you are in a hurry and you don't have enough time to check your campaigns, in that case, you can optimize the campaigns with these bulk operations. Otherwise, I would suggest you can check campaign level data and then do the optimization. That's all about Amazon PPC optimization using the bulk sheet. If you need any help or any questions regarding this, you can email us at info@ecomclips.com. And also, for your information, we provide free 7-day trial and also free audit to any Amazon accounts. So feel free to book a consultation call with us anytime. See you soon in my next video. Till then, stay safe. Thanks for watching.